Peter Sterius, I live in San Luis Obispo, California.
What is the name of the type of yoga that you lead, and what was his name?
His name was Shandor Remete, and that style of yoga is Hatha Yoga. His practice, he studied with BKS Iyengar in India, who's, you know, one of, I guess, three teachers that studied with Krishnamacharya, which was a master teacher in India around the turn of the century. And basically, through his relationship with Iyengar, and he had also started yoga from his father. He was Hungarian by birth. His father was a yoga teacher. And so it was an integral part of his life. And my relationship to him was, he was the first male yoga teacher I ever had. And not only was he a male teacher, but he was a man, like a man's man. And by that, he had fought in Vietnam. He was an Australian Special Forces. He was a black belt in karate, in martial arts. There was a masculine presence in him that was unusual for a male yoga teacher. And really, I related to that aspect of him more initially. Like, that's what drew me to him initially, because I still had that connection to that masculine kind of adrenaline or testosterone fueled being, way of being as a man. And he seemed to integrate it. Like, he seemed to be able to have his feminine and masculine just right up on the table at the same time. And, you know, growing up in the 70s, as a man, I don't know how old you are, but as a man in the 70s, testosterone was not appreciated that much, you know, like the women's movement was getting their feet under them. And, you know, to be a nice, I was bred, you know, growing up, if I look at all my role models in elementary school, junior high school, high school, all women. Like, I didn't have a male teacher until I was in 11th grade in high school. So this era of the 70s where, you know, it was a pretty clear message to me as a man that, you know, having a penis was not an asset in culture, you know, like, the feminine was more attractive to women. And, you know, as a young, you know, as a teenager in early 20s, and now my hormones are starting to kick in where, you know, I want a relationship, and my role model was to be kind of strong in the feminine, you know, like to have that nurturing quality, because women would find that more attractive. And I actually struggled through relationship in those, 10-year period of my 20s, because although that nurturing aspect is attractive initially, if it's too much, it gets boring. And I found in so many of my relationships just crumbling, and I'm like, why? Come on, I'm a nice guy. I'm a peacemaker. You know, I'm gonna make this all right. And it was just, I didn't understand that I so lacked any kind of masculine principle in my life. And so here's this yoga teacher who's got it integrated. And I was like, wow, I'm attracted to this. This is like, I don't have to throw out the bathwater, so to speak. And he taught me a lot. And, you know, he's misunderstood. He's a misunderstood guy. And a lot of people that haven't studied with him for as long as I study with him misunderstand what he's trying to teach, and they only see that macho kind of testosterone driven side of him. And yet I don't see that. I see it in balance. And so that education helped me. And Hatha Yoga, in the word Hatha, is really the integration of the masculine and the feminine. Hatha is solar and lunar principles integrated.